There are multiple ways that you can trim and cut your clips inside of Premiere Pro. Not one way is better than the other. All that matters is which method works best for you. So let's go ahead and see how they work in this tutorial. Hey everyone, Kelsey here, and welcome back to Gal. Today I'm showing you 6 different ways that you can trim and cut your clips inside of Premiere Pro. I'm gonna be starting by showing you how to use the basic razor cut tool to make a simple cut. Then I'll move on to the selection tool, showing you how to trim in and trim out with your mouse, as well as how to use the ripple edit tool, and then a really cool rolling edit tool to move your edit points, and then some more advanced techniques such as slip and slide edits, as well as top tail editing. So you're gonna walk away with a bunch of different techniques that you can start applying to your next video edit. Also, a huge thanks to Oslo for sponsoring today's video. Oslo is a fantastic video review and collaboration tool that allows you to upload your video edits and send them to your clients or sponsors to review with time-coded feedback. I'm going to be telling you more about it later on in the video, but for now you can sign up for a free 5 GB plan using my link below. Thanks so much to Oslo for sponsoring, and now let's go ahead and jump into method number 1. So up first is the razor cut tool. To make a basic cut, press C on your keyboard to activate the razor tool. You can move your playhead to the exact location you want to cut, and then you can just click on this line here, and it will create a cut which will splice the clip into 2. You can then press V to go back to the selection tool, and then you can select the excess clip that you don't want and delete it. You'll see here that there's now a gap that you can select, and you need to delete that gap. But to save time, you don't have to do this extra delete of the gap. You can actually press the Alt key on a PC or the Option key on a Mac, and then press delete, and this will ripple delete the gap for you. If you have multiple clips that are stacked on top of each other and you want to cut all of them at the same time at the same location, what you can do is hold the Shift key and then click, and it will cut all of them at the same time, and then you can just hit the Alt key on a PC or the Option key on a Mac and press delete and delete all the excess clips, and you're good to go. So now let's move on to the selection tool for doing trim ins and trim outs. The selection tool is the default tool that Premiere Pro will default to when you're working in the timeline. If you're on another tool, you can just press the V key on your keyboard to go back to the selection tool. With the selection tool selected, you can simply click on the edit point, and you will see that this icon will be red, and this is the trim icon. From here, you can drag it to the left to trim it in, or you can drag it to the right to trim it out. It's important to note that in order to pull a clip out to extend the edit, there needs to be more footage there. If you pull it out and it stops, that means it's the end of the clip. It's completely maxed out. If you want the trim to hit an exact location, this is where you can make sure that the snapping is turned on just by clicking on the little magnetic icon. If it's blue, that means that it's on. Then you can move the playhead to wherever you want the trim to be, and then you can drag that trim out to meet the playhead, and it will snap to the playhead. So the selection tool is really easy to do simple trim ins and trim outs, but if you're working with lots of different clips in your timeline, it will leave a gap. So in order to get rid of those gaps, this is where you can use the ripple edit tool, which is the next method. To use the ripple edit tool, press B on your keyboard, and then when you hover on the end of the clip, instead of it being red like with the selection tool, it's going to be yellow this time. And here you can ripple in by clicking and dragging the end of the clip to the left. To ripple out, you can click and drag the end of the clip to the right. You'll see that the other clips in the timeline move with the edits, so that way you don't have to worry about the gaps. You see, as I did this, that the clips seamlessly move together, closing the gaps, ripple editing in, so you don't have to worry about creating gaps when you're trimming your clips. The rolling edit is one of my favorite tools because it allows me to change the edit point between 2 clips and move it to any location without changing the duration of those clips. So let me show you how it works. press N on your keyboard to activate the rolling edit tool. Then you can click on the edit point and move it either to the left or to the right to change the location of the in and out points of the source video. And this does not affect the duration of the clips in the timeline. So it's a really cool tool to use if you just need to move this edit point over to reveal a little bit more of that clip to the right. It's just a quick way of making an edit and not having to go through and move and change the duration of your video at all. It stays the same. So before we go into the slip and slide edits, here's a little bit about today's sponsor, Oslo. As a video business owner myself, it's super important that I have an easy tool to share my content with my sponsors and my clients so they can approve it with ease. What's really cool about Oslo is I can upload my final video edit, generate a review link, and share it with my client or sponsor so they can leave time-coded and frame-accurate comments on my video. So if they want something changed, they can highlight something and leave a comment there, and then I'm notified. Or if everything is good, they can say, "Looks great," and then I know that I'm good to publish. Another way that I use Oslo is with my editor, Kristen. I'm able to start a project and I add her as a collaborator so she can upload her final edit. And then I'm notified that she uploaded the first version and I can go in and leave her direct time-coded comments. You can also change the status. So if I reviewed something from Kristen and it's good to go, I can change the status of the project to ready to publish. And better yet, it integrates with my YouTube channel. So I can upload and publish directly to YouTube from Oslo, and it doesn't go public right away. It makes it private, so that way when you go to your actual YouTube channel, you can add in more keywords and content in your end screen before you then go ahead and publish. Here's a few other things that are cool about Oslo. One, you can upload more than just video files. You can upload also PDFs, image files, and audio files. And what I love about this is that I can keep my video thumbnails, which are Photoshop files and PNG files, together with my video. So that way everything's organized and backed up in the Oslo cloud. So it's not only a review tool, it's kind of like a backup storage as well. Another thing that's really cool about Oslo is they have an integrated chat box. So instead of using another messaging tool to communicate with your collaborator, you can just leave a chat and you can tag the person that you want to leave a comment for, and they will get notified and you can have more detailed conversation in the chat box as opposed to the comment thread inside of the actual review section. The Oslo team also told me that they're working on a Premiere Pro plugin as well as a Final Cut Pro X integration, so that way you can receive incoming comments in your video editing software and you don't have to open up Oslo separately, which is really cool. So I've been using Oslo for about 4 months now, and the team has been super responsive to my feedback. I've been super happy with the workflow with Kristen and I in accomplishing the edits and getting the feedback in on time. So if you want to try it out, you can get a free plan that includes 5 gigabytes, which is a decent amount of space for you to trial it out with a few different projects. And if you need more space, you can upgrade to a gold plan, which has 200 gigabytes and more collaborators, or there is the Diamond plan that has 1 terabyte and unlimited collaborators. So check it out. Let me know what you think. And thank you, Oslo, for sponsoring. And now let's get into the slip and slide editing tools. So you might be wondering, what's the difference between the Ripple and the slip and slide? So the Ripple edit tool is great for changing one edit point between two clips. The slip and slide tools are great for changing two cuts in a sequence of 3 different clips. So let me show you how it works. So here I have 3 clips. If I want to adjust the in and out points of the center clip, I can press Y on my keyboard to bring up the slip tool. Now, when I click and hold on the center clip and drag to move to the left, you can see from the program monitor that it adjusts the clip's source in and out points later in time. So the cool part here is that while you're moving the source in and out points of the center clip, the adjacent clips are not affected at all. And also to note, the actual duration of the full video is not affected. While you're changing the center in and out points, you're not changing the duration of all of these 3 clips in the timeline itself. It remains the same. So the slide edit, however, is the exact opposite of the slip tool. The slide edit will actually change the in and out points of the adjacent clips, not the center, but you're still clicking and adjusting the center to use it. So let me show you how it works. So you're going to press the U key to activate the slide tool. And then when you click on the center clip and drag to the left, it'll move the edit of the left clip to an earlier time and the same to the adjacent right clip. So if you go and look in the program monitor as you move to the left, you can see that the in and out time codes of both adjacent clips are moving to an earlier time code. Now, if you drag to the right, you will see that the source time codes are actually moving to a later time. And just like before, after we finish, you'll see that the final video still has the same duration. All we did was adjust the starting and end points of the two adjacent clips. So when might you use the slip and slide tool? So the slip and slide tool isn't really designed to help you edit a rough cut quickly. It's really designed to be used when you're nearly done with your edit and you just need to make a few refinements to a sequence just by moving one of the in and out points of one of these clips, whether it's the center clip or the two adjacent clips. So, you know, you can try it out to see if it's useful. It's not necessary to do it, but it does save you the extra clips of having to move clips over, shift a bunch of clips over, and have to realign them. It's just a quick way to leave everything as is and just quickly move those in and out points. So now, how about editing without a mouse? Top tail editing is a technique where you can edit without using your mouse. You just use keyboard shortcuts on your keyboard. So how does it work? To start, you need to be able to move in your timeline, right? So this is where you use the JKL keys. You press L to move forward in your timeline. You press K to pause, to stop, and you can press J to rewind. So now that you know how to move in the timeline, now you need to know how to make those cuts. And this is used with the Q and W keys. The Q is trimming off the top end of a clip, and the W, by pressing it, will trim off the tail end of the clip. So if you press L on your keyboard, it'll move forward. And then you can press W to trim off the tail end of the clip that you're on as you're moving through the timeline. And let's say you want to rewind, then you can press Q to trim off the top end of the clip. So you just repeat those motions and quickly go through your edit to refine it. So if you want to master this top tail editing method, I made a full in-depth look at how it works. You can watch that tutorial. It's up here in a card. You can click on it and try it out. So all of these methods you can use. Some of them you may use more than others, but the key is that in some cases it's better to use a certain technique. For example, if you have multiple clips in your timeline, instead of using the selection tool, which creates gaps when you trim, you can use the ripple edit tool instead. If you're looking for more inspiration, like how to do more creative cuts like is done in Hollywood films and in commercials, I did make a full video analyzing 7 different creative editing techniques that you can use, such as the smash cut, which is super cool. So if this video helped you out, be sure to give it a big thumbs up. It definitely helps me know if you want more content just like this. And also be sure to subscribe and hit that notification bell so you're notified when I publish new content, because I don't want you guys to miss out. Thanks again to Oslo for sponsoring today's video. Don't forget to sign up for their free 5 GB plan, which is linked just below. And yeah, that's it for today's video. Thanks so much for watching, and I'll see you next time. Bye.